can apply for this particular opportunity. So basically, as I mentioned before, there are three particular positions open for 2020 batch students. One is software engineer, another one is hardware engineer, and the third one is consulting engineer. Okay, so we will check the eligibility criteria, also the skills required for each of these positions. Okay, so first we will check about the software engineer position. So the software engineer position, all these three positions are basically for the location Bangalore. Okay, so the software engineer position Bangalore, the technology interest is software development and testing, job type is new graduate. Here they have provided information about Cisco, which you can read. Okay, so here they have told you actually what is your role for that particular position. Okay, so design, develop, troubleshoot and debug software programs for enhancements and new products. So you can read this. Qualifications, so here you can check recent graduate or on your final year of studies towards bachelor's or master's degree in computer science, computer engineering, electrical engineering, related majors such as maths, physics. Okay, so basically even if you are an electronics or ENTC engineering student, you can apply for this. Main thing is year of pass out is 2020. Okay, so only 2020 batch students can apply. Minimum of 8.5 GPA or higher is required for this particular position. Okay, so if you are into percentage, then just make sure you convert this GPA 8.5 into a percentage and check if you are eligible. Other qualifications which are required are understanding of computer science fundamentals and software engineering with an aptitude for learning new technologies. Okay, so you can read these qualifications. Now, most important thing, immediately after you apply, they are not going to send you some test link. Okay, so you can note, please note that this posting is to advertise potential job opportunities. This exact role may not be open today, but could open in near future. So currently, immediately they won't hire you or immediately the process won't start. But in future, whenever they are having immediate requirement for this particular position, they will try to consider your application. When you apply, a Cisco representative may contact you directly if a relevant position opens. Okay, so make sure that you don't start immediately checking out what are the links. Okay. Now let us check what are the requirements for hardware engineer. So this is another opening. So this is again in Bangalore. Okay, here you can check what are the responsibilities. Okay, so here you will understand what exactly you will have to do. So this is, I think, more related to impact the product development from lowest levels of circuit design to large system design. So you can check here what are the various things which are available or the innovative hardware engineering positions available in this particular post. So here, recent graduate or final year students towards master's degree in electrical, computer engineering, applied science, material engineering, maths, physics. Okay, so these all branch students can apply. Even here you can check for this position, the criteria is 8 GPA. Previously for software, it was 8.5 GPA. Year of pass out is 2020 only. Okay, so this is about the hardware engineer. And the third one is the consulting engineer. Let's check. So here they have told you what actually you will be doing as a consulting engineer. So you can check this, develop complex designs and all those things. You can read this. Here the qualification is, again, you should have a bachelor's or master's degree in networking, computer science and IT, electrical, computer engineering or similar field. And here again the requirement of GPA is 8.5. okay, you should also be fluent in English, verbal and written. So these are the some of the qualifications. Okay, so you can apply any all three or any two or any one of these three positions. Okay, so there is a apply button over here. You can click on apply. So once you click on apply, you need to sign up as a new user. Okay, just you need to enter your email address and click on register now. So once you enter your email ID, okay, so you will be getting this screen when you need to first upload your resume. There are two to three options. Either you can upload a file, you can directly apply with LinkedIn, or you can upload your resume from Google Drive or Dropbox. So once you upload your resume, you need to fill this application. Okay, so currently I'm filling the application for consulting engineer. Similarly, you can fill the application for software engineer or hardware engineer. Okay, so you need to put salutation, first name, last name, middle name, okay, your email address, your phone number. Okay, can we contact you via SMS? You can say yes or no. Okay, whatever. You need to put your address, country, state, city or postal code. Are you looking for an internship or new recent graduate level role? You need to click on yes, since this you are a new graduate. You can put your area of interest. Okay, so whichever position you are applying for, suppose you are applying for software, then click on software. If you are applying for hardware, you can click on hardware. Okay, then here highest degree will be bachelor's degree. Okay, college or university. See, if your college is not listed in this list, it is a big list, you can search for your college name. If it is not listed, then there is one option, other. Okay, so you can click other and put your college name over here. You need to select your majors, that is engineering, electrical engineering. Okay, so let's check what are the options. So you can put computer engineering, electrical engineering. Okay, so if electronics and communication is not there, maybe either you can select other, or here you can select engineering. Okay, so you have got two options. Okay, others can, those are from electrical and computer science, you directly have got option. IT students can directly put computer engineering. See, here they have told most recent job title, most recent employer. If you have done any particular internship, then you can put the most recent job title as intern, and you can put the name of the company where you have done your internship. If you have not done any kind of internship, maybe you can put here new graduate. Okay, so here I can put new graduate, and here also I will put new graduate. Okay, or I can just put not applicable. But if you have done any internship, just put here intern and you put the name of the company. Okay, over here. Have you been issued a Cisco employee ID? You need to select no. Okay, so here you need to put if you have done any certification course. If you have done any certification course like CCNA, then it will be an added plus. Okay, you can select the languages you are fluent in. So here you can put all the skills and technologies, the programming languages, platforms which you have worked on. Here you can, they are asking how did you hear about us. You can select over here the option, proper option. You need to create a password, you need to confirm password. Okay, here sign in for job notifications. If you want any notifications, then you can just select which notifications you want for which area of interest. Okay, you can also select the states which you want. You can select multiple states, and you can here select the alert frequency. Click on notify me for new job. So this part is actually for new job notifications. After filling this form, just click on agree and continue. Okay, here here you need to put your graduation date or expected graduation date. Oh, okay, so here you need to put 2020. Okay, maybe you can put 1st June 2020 whenever you are going to get your whenever you are going to finish your final semester exams. Okay, here you need to choose your academic performance according to your university. So you can either put GPA or percentage or score, okay, or pass fail directly. So you can put your percentage or CGPA over here. After submitting the application info, you will get this page. This is voluntary self-identification. You need to just select your gender and click on continue. Okay, so here is the final submission for consulting engineer full-time. You can just click on submit. Okay, so once you click submit, they have told you that you are successfully applied to the consulting engineer position job ID. Okay, so one important point, similar is the process to apply for software engineer and hardware engineer. You can apply for all three or any one or two of these open positions. Make sure you put your skills and technical achievements and all those things in the application form, and make sure you upload a proper updated resume. Okay, so if you have did not upload a resume, click on my jobs profile below to update it. So you can, if you have not uploaded the resume, you can just upload it over here also. Okay, you need to just click on my jobs profile. So check here, open jobs, you have applied for this. Okay, and the status is in process. Okay, so here you can upload your resume. Okay, once you apply, you will also get an email. You need to read the email properly. Okay, so they have told you that thank you for applying for Cisco. What next? Please upload your resume if you have not uploaded. Okay. So what they are going to do next, we will use the information you provided and assess your background based on the role and requirements. If there is a potential match for the position, we'll contact you to discuss the next steps. After watching this video, you might have questions. When is the online test? What is the location of the test? Okay, or how the test will be conducted. So basically, if your profile gets shortlisted and if they have a particular position open, then they will directly contact you for further positions. Okay, so once they contact you, you need to follow the further steps and process. Okay, so I hope you have understood how you can apply for these